Welcome to Kids for Christ at the Fort Bend Church. I'm Miss Deirdre. I want you to think of a time when something you really wanted seemed too hard to get, or maybe you had to wait a long time to get it. I bet you remember that it was tough waiting for that item or activity. Today, we will hear about something very important that happened and what the Israelites did to help people remember. Sometimes getting a whole team of people to work together can be challenging. Imagine trying to get thousands of people to work together. With God's help, that's what Joshua had to do. We'll hear more of Joshua's story in today's Bible story, and we'll hear about a time the Israelites needed to trust their leader in order to move forward. We're going to learn about how God has worked out his plan to rescue sinners. We can find this story and many others in the Bible, which is God's word. Remember, all of the stories fit together to show God's greatness and our need for a Savior. In fact, as we hear today's story, pay attention to how God showed himself to people. God gave us his word so that we can know him and his son Jesus. Last time, we heard our new big picture question. What is the Bible? The answer is an important truth to understand. The Bible is God's word that tells us what is true about God and ourselves. Maybe you've wondered, is God this or is this really true about me? Well, people have lots of different ideas about who God is and what is true about God's people. Well, the Bible tells us the full truth. As we review our timeline, we know that Joshua, in the first book of the book of Joshua, was the new leader God chose to take Moses' place over the Israelites. We also talked about what a big job it would be to lead so many people. As Joshua and a new generation of Israelites arrived at the edge of the promised land, they encountered a big obstacle. Something deep and wide stood in their way. We shall see what God did. Let's watch today's Bible story, God Stopped the Jordan River, from Joshua chapters 3 and 4.
God had promised that Abraham's descendants would live in Canaan. He would give them the land. After wandering in the wilderness for 40 years, it was time for the remaining Israelites to enter the Promised Land. Now the only thing keeping the Israelites from their new home was the Jordan River. The river was deep and wide. The Israelites could never get across on their own, but God was going to help them. God told Joshua and the other leaders what to do. First, the priests carried the Ark of God ahead to the edge of the river. The ark reminded the people that God was with them. The rest of the Israelites followed behind the ark. Joshua said, "Listen, God is going to do something great. When these men carry the Ark of God into the river, God will stop the water in the river. Then you will know God is with us." The people watched as the priests carrying the ark took a step into the river. God made the water stop. The priests stood on dry ground in the middle of the river. And then all of the Israelites crossed safely on dry ground. God told Joshua, "Choose 12 men to take 12 stones from the middle of the river where the priests are standing. They should put them down in the place where you spend the night tonight." God wanted the stones to be a memorial. A memorial is something that helps people remember a person or event. That people would see the stones and remember that God helped them cross the river. In the future, when children saw the stones and said, "Why are these rocks here?" the people could tell their children that God stopped the water. And everyone would know that God is mighty. The Israelites did exactly what God told them to do. They picked up 12 big stones to make a memorial. Finally, the priests with the ark crossed the river, and the water began to flow again. The river was deep and wide, like it had been before. At last, God's people were in the promised land. God went ahead of Joshua and the Israelites into the promised land. He showed his power to them so that they would trust in him. When Jesus came to earth, he showed his power so people would trust in him and be saved from sin.
Now, let's review this incredible story. So much for the obstacles. Do you remember that long before today's story, God promised Abraham that his descendants would live in the land of Canaan? After wandering in the desert and getting a new leader to take them into the promised land, the new generation of Israelites faced a huge obstacle. Joshua chapter 3, verse 15 tells us that the obstacle was the Jordan River. God spoke to Joshua and told him exactly what to tell the people to do. First, Joshua told the priests carrying the Ark of God would go in front, and then the Israelites would follow. Next, the priests with the Ark were supposed to step into the water. The Israelites obeyed, and God stopped the water. Finally, the Israelites crossed the river on dry ground. Wow. What did God command Joshua and the Israelites to do next? Well, Joshua chapter 4, verse 3 says, God told Joshua to set up a memorial. Does anybody know what the word memorial means? Well, a memorial is something that reminds us of an event or a person. What do you think the stones will remind the people of Israel and their children about? That's right. The 12 stones will remind them of God's power and his faithfulness. God always keeps his promises, and we can find his promises in the Bible. Joshua trusted in God and obeyed him. We can also trust God and obey his word, the Bible. Our Christ connection tells us that God showed his power to Joshua and the Israelites so that they would trust him. When Jesus came to earth, he showed his power so that people would trust him and be saved from sin. Later, when you watch the Questions from Kids video, think about these questions. Why is it important to remember God? What can you do to remember God? After God helped his people enter the promised land, he commanded them to set up a memorial to remember the miracle. Today, for our missions moment, we want to remember Annie Armstrong, whom God used to support missionaries. Women like Annie have been important to missions for a very long time. Many women have given their whole lives to sharing the gospel with people all over the world. Later, after you watch the Missions Moment video, think about the bravery of those women who answered God's call to mission. Men, women, and children can all be a part of the things God is doing all around the world. Our key passage explains why we need God's word. It compares God's word to something we need in order to live. What is it? That's right, it's light. Now, repeat the key passage after me. Your word is a lamp for my feet and a light on my path. Psalm 119:105. Let's sing the key passage song, Your Word, and our worship song, Trust in the Lord. It is so much fun singing the Keep As It song. I hope you sing it this week because it's a great way to help you remember that key passage. Now it's prayer time. Let us pray. Lord, thank you for showing yourself and your power to us through your word. Put your words in our hearts so we can remember your promises and trust in you at all times, even when we face big obstacles. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Now, watch the Questions from Kids and Missions Moment videos. After the videos, work on your activity page. If you need a little help, just ask your parents. This week, I want you to pray and thank God for women in missions. Ask Him to bless their work. Also, pray for missionaries supported by churches all around the world. Remember, subscribe to the Fort Bend Church YouTube channel. Like and share this week's video. Have a great week. Bye-bye.
Hi there. I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Christopher from Mesa, Arizona asks,
I only think about God when I'm at church. Is that okay?
Oh, that is a great question. I am glad you are concerned about how much you think about God. You see, some adults are not even concerned about how much they think about God. So for you to be concerned, that's a really, really great thing. You see, He requires us to think of Him at all times and in everything that we do. His desire is for you to love Him with your whole heart, soul, mind, emphasis there on mind, and strength. You see, this is why we need the spiritual habits, or what many adults would refer to as the spiritual disciplines. Prayer, reading the scripture, singing songs, spending time in daily devotion in our homes or outside of church helps us to think about God more. Here is an encouragement for you. The longer you walk with Christ, the more you should want to think about Him, and the more I think you will think about Him. Paul encourages us to think on things that are above. He tells us to set our minds on heavenly things. And so in order to do that, even when we're outside the church, my encouragement to you would be to pray and to read and to study. Listen, even as an adult, I have to set reminders to remind me to pray and to read my Bible and to spend time and study. In addition to that, I also have family members and friends who help remind me to think about God. Oftentimes, my family members and friends say, hey, have you prayed today? Have you done your devotion today? And so I would encourage you to have family members and friends around you who would help you reflect on how good the Lord has been to you. You see, things that we are excited about, we often want to think about, and we often want to spend time thinking about. So I hope and I pray that the Lord would give you a heart that is devoted to Him, and that a heart that wants you to think about Him and to reflect on Him. I pray that you will be excited about knowing more about God. So, what will you do to help you remember God?
For many years, women have been making an impact for Jesus as missionaries serving all over the world. These women serve specific roles in sharing the gospel with other women in many different nations. Edmonia Moon and her sister Lottie were two of the first women sent to China in the late 1870s. Lottie spent her entire life loving and sharing the gospel with the Chinese people. In the 1900s, more women missionaries headed to China, Japan, and other nations to start community centers. At these centers, women and children attended tutoring programs, exercise gyms, and parenting classes. Female missionaries developed deep relationships that allowed them to naturally share the gospel. Throughout the 1900s, more and more women were obeying God's call to go to other nations to share the gospel. Agnes Graham was one of the first missionaries to Chile in South America. Within 25 years of her arrival to Chile, 50 new churches had started. Ruth Kersey was a nurse who heard about the great medical needs in Nigeria, Africa. So, she left her home to serve the Nigerian people. She opened an orphanage for children and showed the love of Christ to many in this country. In the 1990s, Yvette Ahrens was appointed to be a missionary in Trinidad, an island in the Caribbean. Yvette became one of the few deaf missionaries sharing the gospel using sign language to deaf people around the world. And the list goes on. There's not one type of missionary. Young, old, men, and women, everyone has a role in sharing the gospel with people all over the world.